Welcome back to The Cutting Edge. Throughout these Winter Olympics, there are many stories of both the winners and losers in their respective sports. What remains constant in the Olympic experience is every athlete participating. The story of Stephen Cousins is an example of one such athlete living up to the Olympic ideal.
My job is to skate and to enjoy myself while I'm here. I've never been one that's like, I've got to win. It's all the process. You know, if I can go through the ups and downs of my career, then the rest of my life is going to be a doddle. You know, I know I can handle anything. So for me, that's what this is all about.
This man has a lot of charisma, but for this short program, he is here to compete.
It's a great sense of excitement. Also, you're trying to tell yourself, you know, calm down, you got to breathe. Standing in my starting position just before the music starts, and as the music started, the starting time went 1, 2, and I could see the seconds ticking by, and I go, oh, it's going by quick already. And as I turn around, my next focus was on the Olympic rings. It says Nagano, Olympic rings, 1998, on the side of the board. So that was my focus for the next 35 seconds. And as when I turned around to come back towards that, focused on that the whole time. And then in my mind, as I turned the corner, I said to myself, you can do it. And going into the combo, just as I was turning the corner, I said to myself, you know, you can do this, just like practice. So as I stepped into the combo, I usually look down to make sure the ice is okay. Because sometimes it's a bit rutted, and it was a little rutted. So I waited just an extra foot or two before I jumped. And so I found myself closer to the boards than I would have liked to when I landed the axel. So I just did a double toe loop instead of a triple. But still, it was a nice sense of relief afterwards knowing that it was done. And now I just had to focus on the next thing. Here's the whole deal for me on the Lutz. During the year, I have missed the Lutz once in practice. I would practice and it's been going really well all the time. And then the one time I missed it, I was saying to myself, you know, you can't do this forever. You can't just keep landing it. And then I fell. So then afterwards, this was about 2 weeks ago, afterwards I came back and then did the program right again, because I wanted to clear that from my mind and just say, okay, that was a once off and I'm not going to do it again. So going into it again at the Olympic Games, my mind went back to that. And I said to myself, those are the exact thoughts I don't want. This is what I want to think, that I never miss it. And I went around and I did it. So I was playing some little mind games with myself going into it.
And the mind games obviously work. Stephen placed a respectable sixth after the short program. But those weren't the only mind games clicking behind the scenes of the Olympics.
So now, after we threatened the 1984 Olympic champion, we send up
send
the mail.
Send the mail.
It's been sent, and within minutes we'll get a reply, because I know Scott actually camps out and sleeps right next to his email.
You are the email king.
Thank you.
But the email king did not send the message he wanted at the 1996 World Championship. Fifth after the short program, in the free, he fell to the ice on jump after jump. Doubles became singles, and triples became doubles. The following season, despite 8 years as Great Britain's champion, he lost his national title to an inexperienced 17-year-old after mediocre showings at the 97 Europeans and Worlds. Some around the sport doubted Stephen would even earn a trip to Nagano.
I almost lost all of my self-worth. That was really weird for me, because...
Losing your self-worth?
Yeah, it was very, very strange. I felt like I was clutching at straws with everything, with myself, with people around me. It was very, very weird. And title or no title, you know, life is life, and you gotta have, you know, a good time. You gotta make sure that you spend it how you wanna spend it and be, you know, as good as you can be with whatever you do. Being in the final group, the Olympic Games, going into the long program, I don't care if I don't get a medal. I don't care if I don't skate great. I just care about being where I am and enjoying the moment. For me, just being there, just being able to say, you know what, I was in the last group with all these guys and I had a chance. That's enough for me.
On the ice, representing Great Britain, Stephen Cousins.
In the free program, it would be Rhett Butler that would carry him through to the triple Lutz. No mind games there. Perfect. However, the triple axel would still haunt him.
All week, I've been skating great all the last 2 months. That's probably the worst program I've put together. So to put it together at the Olympics is a little annoying. So because you know, I've been skating better than that, and I expected better of myself. But, you know, that's life.
And he would segue his on-ice character of Rhett Butler to off-ice humor.
Frankly, I don't give a damn.
Well, Steven's going to look back and have awesome memories of this experience. He's going to have a great professional career because he is such an entertainer. And really, when he looks back, not only is he going to have such pride, but he's going to be well-balanced and he's going to be sane. Unlike some of these skaters who are going for a gold medal and maybe come up short with a silver, and you spend the rest of your life wondering, was it a failure? Could I have done better? He's just going to have a great life ahead of him.
Be careful what you say about winning a silver medal.
Hey, I did too.
No, but he really does capture what the Olympic spirit is all about, and he may not have won a medal here, but I guarantee you he did win the gold medal in sportsmanship. And when I think back to my Olympic experience, that's the most important thing, the process, not necessarily the end result.
That's right.